Good morning, everyone. We will tackle about the network layer or
the network layer or OSI layer 3 provides service to exchange the individual piece of data over the network between identified end device. To accomplish this, end-to-end transport, layer 3 uses 4 basic processes. The 4 basic processes of layer 3 are addressing, encapsulation, routing, decapsulation. What is addressing? Addressing is the layer must provide a mechanism for addressing these end devices. If individual pieces of data are to be directed to an end device, that device must have a unique address in an IPv4 network. When this address is added to a device, the device is then referred to as a host. Second, encapsulation. The network layer must provide encapsulation. Not only must the device must identified with the address the individual piece, the network layer must also contain this address. During the encapsulation process, layer 3 receives the layer 4 and adds a layer 3 header or label to create a layer 3 when referring to the network layer. We call this PDU a packet. When a packet is created, the header must contain, among other information, the address of the host to which it is being sent. This address is referred to as the destination address. The layer 3 header also contains the address of the originating host. This address is called the source address. The next is routing. The network layer must provide service to direct these packets to their destination host. The source of destination hosts are not always connected to the same network. In fact, the packet might have to travel through many different networks along the way. Each packet must be guided through the network to reach its final destination. Immediately, devices that connect the networks are called routers. The role of the routers is to select paths for and direct packets toward their destination. This process is known as routing. Finally, the decapsulation. The packet arrives at the destination host and is processed at layer 3. The host examines the destination address to verify that the packet was addressed to this device. If the address is correct, the packet is decapsulated by the network layer and the layer 4 contained in the packet is passed up to the appropriate service at transport. And next, we will tackle about role of IPv4 protocol. The network layer service implemented by the TCP protocol suit are the Internet Protocol version 4 of IP is currently the most widely used version of IP. It is the only layer 3 protocol that is used to carry user data over the Internet and is the focus of the CCNA. Therefore, it will be the example we use for network layer protocol in this course. The Internet Protocol was designed as a protocol with low overhead. It provides only the functions that are necessary to deliver a packet from a source to a destination over an internet interconnected system of networks. The protocol was not designed to track and manage the flow of packets. These functions are performed by other protocols in other layers. Next is packet header. An IPv4 protocol defines many different fields in the packet header. These fields contain binary values that the IPv4 service reference as they forward packet across the network. IP source address contains a 32-bit binary value that represents the packet source network layer host address. IP destination address contains a 32-bit binary value that represents the packet source network layer host address. And the time to live is an 8-bit binary value that indicates the remaining life of the packet. The TTL value is decreased by at least 1 each time the packet is processed by a router. When the value becomes 0, the router discards or drops the packet and it is removed from the network data flow. This mechanism prevents packets that cannot reach their destination from being forwarded indefinitely between routers in a routing loop. And the type of service contains an 8-bit binary value that is used to determine the priority of each packet. This value enables a quality of service mechanism to be applied to highly priority packets, such as those carrying telephone voice data. Protocol enables the network layer to pass the data to the appropriate upper layer protocol. Fragment offset identifies the order in which to place the packet fragment in the reconstruction